muito bom.
This morning I had three paracetamol, stuck two HRT stickers onto my butt cheeks, and I just hope for the best. You know, being in this industry, in musical theatre, it's not easy. It's not easy to make a life from it. And this show and this lady has given across the world thousands of us, a chance, a job, a foot on the property ladder. She helped us get mortgages. She helped us find the loves of our life. You know, marriages, babies, probably affections. But you know, what she's done for our industry has given us a career, backstage and on stage. It's been monumental what she's done for us. And I want to introduce her to you, and I want to bring her on. She is as kind and as beautiful as she is scary. She is the original badass boss. She is the dancing queen. Ladies and gentlemen, Judy Pryor.
This is unbelievable. Thank you for being such an incredible audience to celebrate 25 years of I know many of you were in the audience 25 years ago, and it's exciting you're back. I'm hyperventilating. I'm pleased that my lawyer and my doctor are in the audience. In fact, there's a few lawyers in the audience. But I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for an incredible team, and I know we showed you the little film, but really, we were on a mission 25 years ago, and the wonderful creative team are all up there. Anthony Van Laas, Mark and 70 million people have seen Mamma Mia. 70 million people have seen around the world. And, you know, tonight we've got an amazing cast. I mean, what a cast. And I'm cast. I mean, for 25 years we've had casts. I mean, there's 33,000 rhinestones on these costumes. There's 121 bras uplifting everybody. And it just goes on. So it takes a village, it takes several Greek islands to make this kind of what it is. Not only the team, Phyllida Lloyd, our director, is not here tonight, but she sends her love. She's in New York directing, lucky she's still got work. I wish she was here. But I also have to thank an incredible band. For three beautiful theatres. We've been in the West End so long now, we've had actually three beautiful theatres. this jewel of the theatre that we're in now, and thank you everyone at Delfont Macintosh. That's, you know, we're a big family, and we have lost a couple of people. Andrew Tregus, who was my executive producer, our executive producer. He passed away sadly last year, and he navigated this show into the West End and stampeded us around the world. And Louise Plowright, of course, who was our original Tanya, created that role in 1999. And she passed away a few years ago. And we have here the original cast from 1999, the class of 1999. I need to introduce you to the person that actually wrote this witty, warm, fabulous stage play. She made the other songs sing within a show. I think the story she wrote 25 years ago is incredibly relevant. And I want you to meet her because she is my dynamo conspirator, Katherine Johnson. Oh! All that plastic stuff. Yeah. Nice. And talking of plastic surgery to other people that don't look two incredible women that originated those iconic roles of Donna and Sophie are with us here somewhere. Siobhan McCarthy.
Yeah.
And the majesty of ABBA and the irresistible songs written by Benny and Bjorn, and their support and allowing me the endeavor of saying there should be a stage musical using ABBA songs. And so nothing gives me more pleasure than introducing tonight. The legend, Bjorn Ulvaeus.
Here in the UK. It was the second time I entered that stage that night because me and my three bandmates had been called back to perform our song a second time. Because the juries of the Eurovision final had delivered their verdicts. No point from the UK. We knew that. Despite that, we won, and by the thinnest margin in the history of Eurovision. I think that record still stands. So, on a night like this, it's strange to think that if we hadn't won, you know what happens to those who come number four or number three Eurovision, they're never heard of. After that, If we hadn't won, I most probably wouldn't be standing here today. And this wonderful adventure, which we call Mamma Mia, wouldn't have happened. And I wouldn't have met with all these wonderful people that I've worked with through the years. And that would have been so sad. So I got a lot to thank Waterloo for. But here in this room, I can admit that when I relax at home, put on some music, it is not Waterloo. People often come up to me in the streets, and I can see in their faces they're about to say something which they think, he's never heard this before. And out comes, thank you for the music, Bjorn. And it's very touching. And every time the thoughts, same thoughts go through my mind. The fact that somehow ABBA has managed to touch so many millions of lives around the world, generation after generation. And people ask me, how does it feel for you to know that? And that's a very good question. And very hard to answer. It's a very, very elusive feeling. And it's more to do with gratitude and with humility than pride. Because it humbles you to know that so many people have listened to something you've created and that they've been made happy by it or sad, and that it has meant so much for them in their lives. And it's very, very difficult to fully emotionally grasp that, at least for me. And it's just as well, says my partner. So, who was I thanking? Well, I'm not a religious man, so it wasn't him. I think it must have been kind of a gratitude for the sheer existence of music. Because what kind of a world would we have without music? Music in an uplifting way to make people happy. It is this, it is Mamma Mia. Yeah. Yeah. Well, thank you to all you who have made this possible. The original creative team, a lot of them out there, and all you who have done it through the years and who continue to do it, thank you all. And I might not be here for the next big anniversary, but my avatar will.